This is Pat Cox. Today we're going to be playing some Temur here on Channel Fireball. So I played Temur in the Pro Tour. I did not do very well, but the deck still seems pretty good to me, and it has been putting up pretty decent results lately. So give it a try. I might play it this weekend. I guess the biggest new thing I'm trying is the Scarab God, which people have been splashing like maybe in a third of the deck list I've been seeing online. Basically, it's a powerful card against mid-range decks. If the format slows down a bit, like, it's a thing you can reasonably be doing. It's also like pretty easy to splash. I mean, if you remember, this deck used to basically be Jeskai Saheeli, and you splashed a white card in there fairly easily in Felidar Guardian. And it's kind of a similar thing. You can just put one swamp in your deck and reasonably cast this card between Aether Hub and, you know, Attune with Aether and Serve with Conduit. My mana base is a little different than the ones I've seen, mostly because I see people play a lot of Sheltering Thickets and Lumbering Falls. You know, usually they have like 4-ish total of this kind of card, maybe 5. You know, when I have 5/5 drops in my deck, and even just having a bunch of 4 drops, I really want to be able to hit my curve correctly. Like, you already have the Sanctums and the Spirebuff Canals that come into play tapped after turn 3, so having additional lands that always come into play tapped makes it pretty hard for your 4th and 5th land to come into play untapped. To that end, so I'm still playing dual lands. I have Game Trails, which I don't have that many things to reveal to, though you do get to search with the Tune, which gives you like kind of more things to, like, you just can search for Fortis and hold it because you have a Game Trail or whatever. Also, the cycle lands are actually the land type, so you can reveal your Sheltered Thicket to it. As far as the removal suite, this is relatively standard. You definitely want to Harness Lightning. It is great in your deck because it just can basically kill anything. A Braid is good because, you know, obviously it's a good card, but also, like, the popularity of God Pharaoh's Gift seems to have gone up a little bit in recent, you know, the last week or so. So Destroy an Artifact is pretty relevant. Magma Spray, I'm not really sure. I think I want to play at least one, but I'm not sure about the second of this. It's, like, good against zombies and mono red, but I think mono red is on the downswing, so it's basically like, do you want it just for zombies? Because it is not great against like black green or the mirror. On the other hand, all removal is bad, or at least mediocre, against, you know, ramp and God Pharaoh's Gift decks and control decks and stuff, so it doesn't matter that much if you're playing this or another Braid. But yeah, otherwise the deck is relatively standard. I'm not really sure that not playing 4 Glorybringer is correct. Like, maybe I'm only supposed to play one Scarab God, or maybe just not play at all, because Glorybringer is just, you know, the second Glorybringer is actually, like, very relevant. It's not like, oh, one Glorybringer wins the game. Like, it might win the game, but, you know, you often see opponents, like, complaining in chat, like, man, 2 Glorybringers. Like, you know, the second one usually just puts the nail in the coffin. Okay, so sideboard, generally you want some number of counterspells. It doesn't necessarily have to be negates. These are, like, good, not great against a lot of decks. You know, they can counter God Pharaoh's Gift, or I forget what the card that searched for is called, Gate the Afterlife, maybe. It's okay against control. It is pretty good against ramp, because it can counter both ramping and sweepers. But basically, you know, there's decks where you just, your removal is basically dead, so you want something like this. Confiscation's Coup, I've seen people say that this is a good card against Tazzeret, and we did consider it for the Pro Tour, but it seems really slow. But maybe it's okay because the deck slows down, like mono red decks all slow down so much after sideboard that you're going to probably play a longer game and Tazzeret will just kill you. I'm not really sure. I think it is like pretty decent in the mirror and like fine against green black and stuff. Like, it's a card that's sort of like negate, just okay in a lot of places. So may or may not end up playing that. Chandra's Defeat, because like I just said, the red deck's kind of sideboard into Chandra Glorybringer, so this is a great card against them because it lets you like hedge and leave in something that kills cheap things or kills their giant stuff if that's what they have. I'd probably also side in the mirror because Chandra and Glorybringer are important cards there. The Radiant Flames and Sweltering Sun, maybe should all be white Radiant Flames, but these are mostly for zombies. I guess if you played against like Monument or something, you'd also side them in. But mostly for zombies, same thing with Shrine of Flamecaller. You'll still side this in against decks where like you just need a side out removal and this is like an acceptable card, but it's mostly just sweepers are really good against zombies. Like one for one removal doesn't necessarily get the job done. Dissenter's Deliverance, this might just be like too greedy to not play in a braid. My basic thought here is just that like against control, you know, you don't necessarily want to have to leave in a bunch of removal spells, but you do have to kill their Gear Hulk when they play it. So this lets you kind of have a flexible card that you can just cycle away if you don't have any gas and, you know, they haven't played a target for it. And obviously, just I do want more artifact destruction against God Pharaoh's Gift decks. Tireless Tracker and Bestiary are both kind of just my grindy cards, mostly against control. Not really sure which of these I should, like, if it's one and one is correct, or, you know, basically I'm just trying to try them out. You know, this is pretty hard for control to remove, whereas Tracker is pretty easy, but you just get like one card off of it and it snowballs really well if they don't do anything about it. This is more like a sit and play forever, but also is not like inherently pressuring them, like you're not going to like win a fast game off of this. Sky Sovereign is good against zombies, and also Black Green. It's also like fine in the mirror. Basically just any kind of deck with a bunch of creatures, it is pretty good against. Harvesters are pretty much from Rhino Red, though it's possible in Swiss Sediments zombies. I don't think so. It is hard for them to kill this card, but I don't think it's enough better than your other cards that you should be bringing it in. But anyway, it is a fairly reasonable card against Mono Red. The only kind of problem is, like I said, they kind of slow down and try and become more of a controlling or at least toe-to-toe mid-range deck with you after board. So, you know, a thing that like blank small creatures is not as good. Like, it's possible that you should just play one of these or both of these in your main deck and just plan to side them out against everything but red, because like they're better game one against red. I don't know. Anyway, this is the list I'm trying. The main thing I'm trying is Scarab God, but I'm also kind of unsure about a few sideboard cards. So let's join a league and see how it goes. This is Pat Cox. Welcome back to Temur League here on Channel Fireball. This opening hand is not great. This is kind of the price you pay for putting a bunch of expensive cards in your deck. Like, I don't think we can reasonably keep this. I mean, if we're playing against a deck where we knew these removal spells were great, maybe, but 2-5 drops with only two lands, we should probably be mulliganing. Also not great. You know, if the first hand had a servant, I would be actually pretty excited about it. Now, if this hand had another land, I would be at least fine with it. I think we have to mulligan again. I mean, we get two shots to find a land, but then we still need another land, so it's not like it's solving all our problems. So, mulligan again. Alright, well, not great, but we are going to be able to cast this Chandra, so we'll keep. That's interesting. It's like, can't even cast it right now, but do we want just as many inherently powerful cards as we can because we're like behind on cards? Like, this is a card advantage card, but so is Chandra, and this is like not going to protect Chandra. Like, I want to play something before Chandra Protector, I think. So I'm going to put this on the bottom, but I might be wrong. I'm also stupidly thinking about this when I'm just going to attune. I don't have to attune this turn. Like, if I left something on top, I probably would not attune. But I guess since I put it on the bottom anyway, I should. I think we just want Mountain so we can cast this Chandra. Okay, so we're probably playing the mirror. You know, they played Lumbering Falls. I'm not sure if there's other decks that play that, but I don't think so. Alright, well, I think we need to cycle this thicket. So, let's just play the Mountain. Pass turn. Didn't really pay that close of attention to lands I picked, but it's kind of cool looking at the bolus lands next to each other. Alright, sure, you get a servant, I'll cycle. Wish I had a servant, and I could Chandra and their servant, but, you know. Alright, well, Bristling Hydra was not a great draw. Could harness lightning here. Like, this is not inherently a huge threat, but aside from Glorybringer, there's not that much stuff that's that worth killing with Harness Lightning. because you can't really, kill a Bursting Hydra. So just probably to prevent them from playing a Chandra and kind of keep the board clear, I think I just want to Harness Lightning this. And the reason to play Aether Hub instead of Forest here is because we have those game trails in our deck where you have to reveal Forest. So basically, if at all possible, you want to leave a mountain in your forest or forest as your last land in your hand. So here we're basically just trying to hamstring them a little bit and to slow the game down, because we're like okay if we can get this Chandra into play with a relatively clean board. Yeah, like that's fine. They can't even play their own Chandra next turn. Mountain was a good draw. We don't have to use any energy now. So I think I just kill this. They can make it up to a 3 with energy. Yeah. Given that they can't really do much threatening next turn, like they can't kill my Chandra next turn, I think I just want to kill this. I'm assuming they're not two-color energy, they're just missing a color, but I guess they found it now. They have a Hydra. Yep. Well, I also have a Hydra, so luckily I can still protect my Chandra pretty easily. Should play my land first in case I hit a Glorybringer. I'm not even sure if it's correct to cast Glorybringer, but probably just going to deal 2 to them unless it's something I can use defensively. Alright, well, it was a Botanical Sanctum, it shows down here in the bottom. Alright. Now, hopefully they do not have Redland, Glorybringer, / Chandra. Both would kill my Chandra right now. They could obviously just plus their Chandra, not cast a card, deal 2, redirect to my Chandra. You know, given that I'm down, 3 cards or whatever, I mulligan to 5, but also, like, they were on the draw, I really need this card advantage to stay in play. Another thing I have to kind of be wary of is this Lumbering Falls. Like, if I trade away the board and I have Lumbering Falls, ugh, that's also not great for me. Well, it's going to be difficult for me to win this game. Like, a Glorybringer right now would be good. Don't know if it's good enough, but it'd be good. I can trade off Hydras. Okay. I don't know what I would draw that would change that I have to attack with Hydra, so go ahead and do that. I'll attack Chandra. Basically, I assume neither of us are going to use energy, but like they have to have like a lot of energy for them to eat an opposing Hydra. It's like you need 3 more than your opponent has. I guess, no, more than that, right? Because you have to, like, if he pumps twice and I pump once, my guy still kills his. So he needs 6 more energy than me. So, hasn't really come up. Usually, Hydras just trade with each other. I guess I'm looking for, a Long Tusk Cub or something. Something where Chandra can't just keep the board clear on her own. Well, that is not what I was looking for. Doesn't really help me in any way. Like, I don't have anything that costs 6 in my main deck. I guess at least they whiffed on a spell. Alright, well, Hydra can effectively block my Rogue Refiner. Yeah, I think it's extremely unlikely that I win this game, but give it another turn or two. In that, in two turns, I'll just ultimate Chandra, and I will be super dead. If you guys have not had the pleasure, Chandra gives you an emblem that whenever you cast any spell, you deal 5 damage to a creature or player. So usually you're just going to direct it at them, because probably just going to kill them within like 2 activations or something, but anything, you know, just using it as board control is also pretty good. Don't get me wrong, ultimate should be good. It's not like a big deal that it's good, but I don't want to be facing it right now is all I'm saying. Alright, I guess I should just kill something with this. It's not doing anything else for me. Well, I think we can concede, because we're not going to be able to keep Chandra off ultimate. Like, if we drew another removal spell there, you know, we just attack with both guys, let one guy be killed, but at least keep Chandra off ultimate, and, like, maybe top deck a Glorybringer or something, but that's not going to work. Okay. So, don't really like Magma Sprays. I also don't think a Braid is particularly good. I mean, it might be like a necessary evil if you think they're going to bring in Sky Sovereign and are afraid of that. But it, you know, basically like all the small creatures can easily trade with each other, or you can just be killing them with like Chandra Glorybringer, so you're mostly concerned about killing Glorybringer. Do want Coup. It's pretty good to steal their creature and keep it. I guess Sky Sovereign might be fine, though that's a lot of 5 drops. Like, maybe I should just leave it in a Braid. Could also bring in Tracker, but this has not seemed like particularly good in the mirror to me. It's like okay. You know, the games kind of get a little bit snowbally and often end up, you know, Bristling Hydra is just, like, protected. Like, basically what just happened is not uncommon, but it could also happen with a Glorybringer instead or whatever, where one person is just, like, pretty ahead, so, like, accruing small value doesn't matter all that much. So, yeah, I think this is, like, probably too many 5 drops, but I guess I kind of want to try them. It's like, I know this is good. I'm not really sure about these other cards, so possibly making my deck really bad, but yeah, I don't know. Maybe I have to take one of these out. Like, is Sky Sovereign that good in the mirror? I mean, it just kills, like, an irrelevant creature. It is good that it threatens Chandra, but I guess I can just take out, like, yeah, whatever. We'll see about this. Like I said, I'm I'm testing the deck right now, so I kind of have random stuff on the sideboard. This isn't really like, oh, I have all the ins and outs figured out. Scarab Gods are kind of throwing me off a little bit. Got extra 5 drops in my deck. Probably too many. Alright, well, I'm at least not getting punished right now by having all my 5 drops in my hand. So I'll keep. It's kind of interesting thing to figure out is if it's correct to play Long Dusk Cub or Servant first. Like, in general, you kind of want to, like, against decks with, like, red removal or, like, you know, toughness-based removal, you want to probably play the Servant first, because you could potentially, like, have enough energy by the time you play the Cub to, you know, make it so that it can live through that removal, but at the same time, like, the Cub is pretty snowbally. So, like, it's better to get it going as soon as possible. I didn't reveal there because, like, they have no 1 drops. There's nothing that I could cast, so I give them information about my hand, since I don't really want to cast them out or play them out in next turn because I want to reveal it to my other game trail if I draw it. Anyway, so like generally you'd rather they kill your servant, but I don't have any blue mana, so well, because the other hand, turn three Chandra is really stupid on the play, so I think this is probably worth risk. But if I didn't have the ramp, I'm not sure. Maybe I'm supposed to play Cub there. Like, if I didn't need the ramp. Alright, you got me. Well, it's not a blue land, but, you know, it does mean I can cast my Chandra, so I like that. And I play the forest, or sorry, I play the mountain over the forest because I definitely want red-red next turn. And like I said, I do want to be like sandbagging a land in my hand, so just kind of, if I drew some other lands, I still want to be able to keep the like the, one of these in my hand, not have to play the mountain out. Well, now I'm not sure. I can attack, but I will end up having to. Maybe I should just like plus and harness lightning, then attack. That sounds okay. Like they'll attack my Chandra with 2 1-1s. I don't care that much about that. Yeah, that sounds fine. Now, I really need some blue mana. It's like, I've not actually had a problem getting blue mana in this deck up until this game, I believe, barring like mulliganing to oblivion. But, you know, this deck is actually quite consistent, so. Unfortunate that I have blue mana, especially since I don't really have a lot of untapped sources at this point. Basically, my island or one of four Aether Hubs. So now they can either chump or my long tusk hub gets bigger. That is interesting. I guess they just don't have an answer to the cub, because being able to better pressure Chandra with two Thopters instead of one does sound pretty good to me. I mean, I don't know what their hand is. They could have a Glorybringer that's just going to easily deal with the Chandra later. Alright, well, they have Harvester, so definitely should have left in a Braid, I guess. Alright, well, more things I cannot cast. Also cannot attack. Alright. Not going well, not going well. I guess probably the best card I could have found there would be Attune, because it's it would let me cast my hand. Guess maybe I was too hasty with the Harness Lightning. Like, I would rather be able to kill this Aether Harvester. Not sure. Alright, so I guess they're going to attack Chandra for 4. Maybe they just don't care about my cub anymore. Might have drawn an answer. Okay. Come on, blue source. Oh, good. Well, I have actually played a little bit of Scarab God so far, and it's been, you know, fine. But this is not showing it in the most positive light. I draw my second copy that I am unable to cast. Nope, can't cast that. I think it is extremely unlikely I win this game. Like, they can kill my Chandra next turn. And I would have to trade with Lurog Tusk Cub if I block, which I think I need to do. I guess we're seeing... I am showing you guys the power of Temur energy just on the wrong end of it. Which, you know, I'd rather I was the one winning, but anyway, you can see it's how it is a functional deck. I mean, I'm not really clear on why this is a particularly good card in the mirror. Like, maybe this didn't have anything else to bring in. But, I mean, it could just be, and I'm just missing it. Like, I guess it is good at blocking Glorybringer, like, because you just activate it after they attack, so they can't kill it with it. Alright, me, Chandra, okay. Yeah, I don't have any way to catch up here. Like, I didn't side in my big Chandra. Didn't really pay close attention because I was busy opining the mirror. But yeah, they have... They're casting Bristling Hydra meant that they have enough energy to pump their cub more than once. Meaning my cub blocking is not great. I don't know how I would win if they attacked with... Yeah. They're getting a bunch of energy this turn. Like, I think I'm just dead. Okay, well, let's play another round and see how it goes. Okay, so we are on the draw here. I think this is a keep. I guess the main question is, should I play Sheltered Thicket on turn one? We'll see what we draw. It's another land? Probably not. You know, basically this lets me play Scarab God on turn four. Since I'm going to go turn two, one of these guys, turn three, one of these guys. So if I miss a land, I guess I can play this on turn three. Yeah, so since I can play it on turn three and they're playing something where Magma Spray is not good anyway, I assume. Like, they're probably blue back control or something, I'd probably rather have the option to cycle. Well, yeah, now we can cycle it, so. There we go, we did it. So they probably have a Fatal Push. I guess, given I have a bunch of lands, I'd rather they kill my Servant. Well, they didn't have it, so now I wish to play Long Tusk Cub. Oath of Jace. I guess they almost certainly have their own Scarab Gods, which makes Magma Spray a not totally dead card. I can double it up with some other removal spell and exile their Scarab God. That has come up before. But it's not like I'd be leaving Magma Spray in against them. Well, that sort of indicates to me that they have another expertise, but I guess whatever. Could leave up Harness Lightning, and that could protect my cub from expertise, because I can go lightning for zero, and then my cub has enough energy. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that, but given that I probably just would rather cycle than deal two to them anyway, I think I'm just going to pass turn. Weird that this triggers when it's zero. Like, also, what are they waiting for? Alright. Anyway. It's definitely possible it's just bad to, like, save my cub with Harness Lightning, but it's mostly just, like, there's not a lot to do with it anyway. Like, it's basically like what I was talking about, doubling up against the Scarab God.
So because of that, it could just be right.
Okay, they tanked for a while, but they have decided to do nothing with Heroes of Jace. They didn't play a Flash Planeswalker. Well, as anticipated, they did have another Yhany's Expertise, so let me see. I have to use one energy to cast this, go down to two, then I'll go up to five, which means if I use four of that, my guy will live, so this is not... Just making sure I'm not doing something really stupid. So I want to do it for zero. And not, like, literally this exact play with Yhany's Expertise, but the whole, like, using Harness Lightning just to make energy does come up, like, a fair amount in this deck because, you know, you just play against decks like this where your your Harness Lightning doesn't do anything. Or also just sometimes, like, between this and Hydra, like, you can just get surprise damage out of nowhere, either, like, as a combat trick, which doesn't matter that much because you can just kill someone as a combat trick, but more if, like, they're pretty close to dead and they didn't block or something. Ooh, good target for Magma Spray. How lucky. So I guess now we want to play our Sheltered Thicket. Because we want to play our Scarab God on turn 5. And we'll see what we draw, but... I guess also just... We don't have another red mana, and we might just... draw any of our double red cards. You know, we have a lot of Chandra and Glorybringers in our deck. Well, I guess they don't care about gaining life or getting cards back against me. Alright, well, the game trail was a nice draw, because I can reveal a Sheltered Thicket to it. We did it. And also, I don't have to waste any energy on this. That might be stupid, because they could just Scarab God. I'm not sure. I just don't have an answer to that, really, anyway, with only the one Magma Spray. And there's a decent chance they chump. So I'd rather just kind of get rid of this problem for later, when I have such a marginal card anyway. And I guess, of note here, which I kind of glossed over, they're not only a blue and black deck. I don't know if they're a Delirium-type deck, or what's going on. They still seem more or less like blue-black control, but... Like, you know, they might have Ishkana on their deck. Probably have various green cards, like Vessel or whatever, that put cards in their graveyard. Strategic Planning is another one that does that. I think this deck very well could be like a good thing to play right now. It seems like it's probably pretty bad against red, but it seems like it goes over the top of the mid-range type decks like what I'm playing, but not like so extremely that it's like has no chance against zombies or whatever. I mean, if you're main decking Yhany's Expertise, you're probably okay against zombies. Alright. Well, I kind of don't think they have counterspells in their deck now, so I guess I'm safe to just attack with my Long Tusk Cub and then play Scarab God. It's like if they have Sensor or something, it is pretty bad to get my Scarab God censored. Like, who cares if they kill it? You just don't want it to get... I guess also of interest is what do we think they took, given that they discarded a Scarab God. I've not played against this sort of deck yet, so I don't really... know everything that's in it. this is kind of just, I saw Sam Black suggest a deck like this, so basically basing it on that. Of course, if they don't have a Scarab God or a way to kill this, like, this is probably going to take over the game now, because I can just get back one of their stupid cards, like Noxious Gear Hulk. Yeah, this is probably pretty good for me. I suppose I didn't really consider that Liliana can get back to Noxious Gear Hulk first. That's not great for me. Like, I'm still okay because I have Harness Lightning and can just kill their Liliana. I guess I can also just make them chump with Noxious Gear Hulk, which is fine. This is a card I thought would be a lot more played than it has ended up being played, because it is quite powerful. It seems like at its best against this deck, it's like the random Gideon type ability of making creatures actually like helps you with Delirium, but now what should I do? It's like I can make them chump block, or I could just definitely kill Liliana. I think I'd rather put the Scarab God back into play, so I guess I make them jump block. I mean, yeah, I think that's fine. I also, like, they might just think I'm not able to recast Scarab God if I use the energy. Which I actually would not be able to if I had not got this attuned with Aether. Alright, pause for a second there while they were thinking. Yeah, I will attack Liliana. Longtusk Cub is like a weird card where it's either pretty awful because it just dies to every removal spell that's played in the format, or it just gets totally out of control. Like, there's not that many games where it's mediocre. It's very swingy. Like, you start connecting with it, man, this card's good. And I do think this deck has a good amount of energy sinks. Like, it's not like a Marvel deck where you're, like, competing with yourself and can never use them. It's just pretty obvious, or at least, you know, interesting when to use them. And, you know, compared to, like, the old Saheeli deck, sometimes, because you only had Whirl or Virtuosos to use energy in that deck, sometimes I would just end up with, like, 20 energy in that deck and nothing to do with it. It's pretty uncommon for that to come up here. Just you have, what, 11 creatures that make use of it, ignoring Servant, like, make use of it in, like, useful ways, either turning them into plus one counters or Thopters. I'm not going to say this is why I play this deck, but a plus side to playing a deck that makes Thopters is I get to use my token. I don't know if that's kind of a faux pas using a token of yourself, but I think the art's really cool, so I like using it. Alright, so they have made a zombie. Let's see what else they got. Gonti is annoying. This deck is really sweet. I have no idea if it's good, but it, like, looks really fun to play. So, I got the Gonti covered with my Harness Lightning. But the question is, Should I instead Noxious Gearhulk? Like, I'm going to steal one of his cards next turn from his graveyard. I mean, I don't want my Server of the Conduit. He has some sweet stuff over here. I keep saying he, apologize, they. I have no idea of the gender of my opponent. But regardless. Or I could take Champion of Wits because I don't want them to flash it back next turn. I guess given that they tapped out, I can just Champion of Wits, I think. Yeah, I mean, drawing four cards is pretty good. Don't really want them to do it. I'd rather I draw four cards. So... not that I have any guarantee they're going to get seven next turn. And I am going to be kind of annoyed if they bring back Noxious Gearhulk, but they need, like... another Liliana. I mean, they're not going to be able to, like, pulse it back and cast it next turn or whatever, so. Yeah, I would like to draw four cards. That sounds fun. Alright. Discard two? Is it both lands? Probably, right? Like, I can just tutor up a land with my attune. Yeah, I think it's both lands. And I get to scry also. Which is pretty nice. Fortunately, it's life loss. Oh yeah, we'll put that on top. Oh yeah. So we can't like redirect to Leon or anything, but it doesn't really matter. So now we're seeing the good side of Scarab God. You know, we saw the bad side last game where it did nothing and couldn't cast it and all of that, but now I'm getting some nice value. Don't really want this to eat anything. So, I guess just kill Liliana. I mean, they're pretty close to dead, so it could be right to just attack them, but it just seems like why let them have this thing in play that, like, brings back a Gearhulk and stuff. Like, it's going to be pretty hard for them to come back from this, like... again, I don't know their whole deck, but, you know, unless they got, like, a Nicol Bolas or something hidden in here, you know, just playing, like, an Ishkana or something is probably not going to do it. Actually sure that I Glorybringer. It's like they're probably gonna, I want to like remove their Champion of Wits basically. Cannot do anything about that. Yeah, I don't really want them to cast Champion of Wits next turn or flash it back or whatever it's called. What's it called? Eternalize. So I think I can just hang out. Like, I don't really need to play this Glorybringer. Like, kept it on top because it's a Glorybringer. It's great, but... I don't want this. Possibly if I could do two things in the turn, I would want it. Like, Glorybringer and use Scarab God, but since I can't, I don't want it. Yeah, that's fine. Who cares? Like, I could use my Harness Lightning to save my champion, but I don't think that makes sense. Like, I don't really care if that happens. Just get it back now. Man. their deck is built for Scarab God to be like a great thing to be doing. So it's pretty lucky that I have mine online and they don't have theirs. Well, probably don't need this other Scarab God. I don't think I can make any use of it. And then, should I discard a land? Probably does not really matter that much. I guess I want another blue so I can eventually start Scarab Godding twice. So play that. And I guess just Servant, because like I can just, with my current mana situation, I can use Scarab God twice next turn. Well, they're traversing. Let's see what the best thing they can get is. I mean, probably Noxious Gear Hulk, right? Given that they cannot cast Ishkana right now. Noxious Gear Hulk, yeah. That's fine. I think I can cast Scarab God and use it to get back their Noxious Gear Hulk next turn, right? Man, what a stupid card, really. I just hope I remember to bring it back to my hand in real life. I feel like that's like my biggest concern. So I guess it's a good place to be. So 1, 2. So basically, this is just coming to play that land. So 1, 0, 5. Yeah. All right. I have enough. Well, my pondering of what's better between this and Glorybringer. Like, clearly, Glorybringer is a really good card, but it is not even close. This game about like which is gonna do more work. I think my opponent's right now thinking, like, man, this is what I've been doing to people? This is really unfun. That was great. I don't know what I want against this deck. I've never played against this deck before. I mean, a Braid doesn't seem very good. Magma Spray also doesn't seem very good. I guess a Braid kills Noxious Gear Hulk. And Magma Spray does kill Champion of Wits, but did I see anything else it killed? You guys can't see me, but I'm like, I have my head in my hands, and I'm like, closing my eyes, trying to like really think through the last game. I guess I could go back and review the video if I really wanted to. I don't think I want Negate. Like, maybe it's okay. It just seems like so much of what they're doing revolves around creatures that I don't know if it's actually reasonable to try and do that. I mean, I definitely want this. Killing Scarab God sounds pretty good. Tracker's probably good, as is Bestiary. I think we side out some combo of Magma Sprays and Braids. I also don't think War Virtuoso is going to be particularly good against them. Though who knows if they leave in all those expertise. They don't do a lot. I don't think this is good. I could also side in Deliverance to kill Gear Hulk. Like, a Braid just doesn't do that much. I don't want a Braid. Maybe one Magma Spray is okay to kill a Champion of Wits. Like, I guess they could also have Servant of the Conduit, I don't really know. Harness Lightning is definitely the MVP removal spell. And after that, it's just, what else do we want? Like, I guess you could double up with Magma Spray, like in these things, and just actually exile things, which is okay. I don't think that's what I really want to be doing, though. Sky Sarvan might be okay. It threatens Liliana. Maybe I should just be doing that. Yeah, I'm in. Just side into 1,000,007 drops every round. I'm sure that'll work out great. I guess it stands to reason they probably have Servant. I don't know. They have, like, there's plenty of things you can cast for 2 mana to just put things in your graveyard, so they might not. I don't want this many. I really don't know that I can have as many 5 drops on my sideboard. It's like, I always want them, but then I'm just like, well, what if I just get all of them in my hand and can't cast them? Alright, this hand is not insane or anything, but it's certainly a keep. Has good mana. Alright, so play my game trial, real forest. Tune for an island so I can cast these rogue refiners. Not sure what I tune for next. Probably a mountain, because I already have a Glorybringer. Like, I do potentially want to be able to cast Scarab God. Man, that is... holy... that is aggressive as hell. I only have one card that it matters for the side. What I... oh, man. Really? It's crazy. Yeah, I think I need to get... mountain. I think. I guess my Scarab God has just become worse anyway. This also is, like, a good card against them. Like, they use their graveyard a lot. I guess you can just never use the second ability, though. So, yeah. I mean, maybe. Maybe it's fine. If you really don't have any ways to kill the Scarab God, this, like, kinda kills it. Like, it makes its ability not able to do anything. And the, you know, not to totally ignore my Rogue Refiner here, the draw of Lumbering Falls was pretty nice, because it means I can play Glorybringer. I think I'm fine trading here. I have a lot of value going on. Joke's on you, I have another Rogue Refiner. It's possible I'm supposed to play Whirler right now, but I think I want to do this when I don't really know what I want to do with my energy yet. I will say it is pretty nice that I have cast 3 spells this game, and I still just have 7 cards. Like, Attune, you know, is basically a land, but, like, the energy is definitely doing a real thing in my deck, so. Well, I could play a Glorybringer next turn just to kind of get them dead as soon as possible. I don't know that that's correct. Like, they're going to have to tap to play something at some point, and then I can just kill that. I don't really want to give them, you know, the turn where they can just take off and kill my Glorybringer and then play their threats. Given that I can use all of my mana, just Rogue Refiner plus Long Tusk Cub, I think that's still a pretty good turn, so let's just do that. Have to play my forest yet. That's good. That is good. do not want to ever play my forest until I draw my other game trail, or I don't care about lands coming to play tapped anymore. Which is pretty hard to be ever. Like, I have Lumbering Falls in play. So if they have Expertise here that just doesn't do anything, I guess if they have Fatal Push and Expertise, then they can... Yeah, there you go. I mean, still, I've used one card so far, basically, so... Like, I'm just playing a land for a turn, then playing something that replaces itself every turn. Okay. I guess it should have been the tapped one? I don't know. Doesn't really matter. Unfortunately, getting kind of mana screwed over there. They, you know, doom falling to kill a random creature that replaced itself is not really what you want to be doing. Maybe they're supposed to take my hand, but they're just too far behind. I think I want to either Virtuoso or Hydra this turn. It's probably Hydra that, like, plays around them having Yhenny's Expertise. I mean, they certainly don't have it, or they would have cast it last turn, but drawing Yhenny's Expertise. Like, Virtuoso letting you go wide is good against a deck with a bunch of removal, but not good against mass removal. Alright, let's see. Tapped poorly there. Should have left up a mountain. Should have tapped Aether Hub instead. If I need to harness lightning, then I'm wasting an energy. Especially relevant if they play something with like two toughness, where, you know, I care about my energy in chunks of three. So if I could net an energy from harness lightning and get up to 15, that'd be good. All right. Well. This is probably not going to do much. I guess they can get back Noxious. I keep saying this, and then I look over and they have Noxious Gearhulk in their graveyard, and I'm like, no, it's going to do a lot. I'm just dumb. I mean, I guess it is only killing Rogue Refiner, so I actually don't care that much, but. Well, I could Harness Lightning this. I don't actually think I need to. Like, this is why I've been holding on to the Glorybringer. It's not that my Harness Lightning's doing much else. Yeah, that's like kind of a spew though. Alright. I don't think I want to like waste mana exiling this. Or sorry, waste a card exiling this. Let's see here. I want to attack Liliana and Exert, and then I want to attack them. Then, do I want to pump? Because I can just turn these all into 1/1s. I don't think I want to pump. Like, I'll leave myself the ability to cash in for 1/1s if somehow the board gets really bad for me or something. You know, like an Ishkanah could clog things up like a reasonable amount. Still probably better just keep pumping my guy at that point, I guess, so. Alright, well, I guess I will Magma Spray their Scarab God. It's like, one of the ways they could get back in this game is like Noxious Gearhulking me and stuff, so screw that. Eek. don't think there's any merit to waiting a turn or anything. I guess you just kill this. It's like, I could play Virtuoso. They're pretty close to dead next turn anyway. Like, they have to have a way to kill Glorybringer. So I think I'd rather just Beast Jerry. Like, if they claw back into the game, I don't really want to, like, have speed off value. Like, that might be wrong. Might be a little too conservative. It's probably, like, kind of close. I guess I would have to figure out if they're, like, literally dead if they kill Glorybringer, but I get the Virtuoso still. Well, I can kill three things right now. That's not quite enough. But I will probably just kill the Ishkana to make my life easier. Do not want to Spire Bluff Canal. Chandra is good. Does this, like, change what I do this turn? Like, I could Chandra then plus to harness lightning. It is technically another removal spell, but I don't have 8 mana, so it's not really another removal spell. I mean, I could team up, and Chandra could kill Glorybringer, or sorry, Chandra and Glorybringer kill Ishkana, but doesn't really sound that good to me. I actually don't think I even need to cast Chandra, though it might be right too, just because it, like, it might be right. Does play around sweepers better, like it's a threat to leave in play that they can't really kill. Well, they have to jump block anyway, so. I will not exert. Could conversely just play Whirl or Virtuoso and draw a card, that also seems fun. Not played a land yet, I don't think, so. That could help me with that. Not really these play land exactly, but if I really needed to play land, I could have taken my stupid coming to play tapped land off the top. Alright. I have no idea if I think the last couple turns were probably not, they were not necessarily optimal. They might have been optimal. It is like, I'm pretty far ahead, so it doesn't matter that much, but that's probably not a good way to, like, do things. Alright, well, they did have the expertise that I was kind of trying to play around a little bit, but I don't know what this is going to do for them. They would have to have, they have to have some other thing that, like, now finishes this off. Which I guess they didn't even have a, is the spell resolved now? They don't even have a thing to play off of it. So I guess the hope was I had F6 there to my Hydro die. Alright, well, that was actually a pretty sweet match. I mean, that game was kind of not great, but game one was really cool. Like, their deck is, seems really fun. I'm glad I kind of got to play their deck by having the god and using all of their cards. Hey, this is Pat Cox. Welcome to another round of Temur here on Channel Fireball. This hand is pretty suspect. Like, my only red mana is Aether Hub, meaning I kind of have to wait till I cast Whirl or Virtuoso before I cast any of my other red spells. Like, I do have plenty of red source in the deck and plenty of waste back energy. Could also just kill something with Harness Lightning that just doesn't cost or doesn't have three toughness. I guess this is a keep, but it is, like, pretty close. Okay, well, they're going to give me an opportunity to harness lightning something that has lower toughness. So I guess I'm happy about that. Clunky hand is not really what you want against Dread. Like, Virtuoso is one of my best cards against them. Maybe my best card. But I need to actually be able to have energy to use. Alright, so I'd say play like Carry Zev post combat. I would clearly have rather killed that with Harness Lightning. But I suppose I can take one and give myself options. Like, I can always like just use Rogue Refiner and have some energy to cast stuff later. Alright. I think Courier is probably the scariest of these cards, actually. This card can get a little bit out of hand, so. Alright, now do I cast Whirler or Rogue Refiner? Probably Whirler. Guess I F6 too fast. Talk about my mana pool, and I'm also have something in play. So, if not obvious, why this card is good against them is because they have several cards that make a creature unable to block, but you can just make this creature after they do that. Here's a good example, Earthshaker Kenra. The other plus side is that a 1-1 trades with quite a few of their creatures. Now, I'm guessing if they're doing this, they probably have a shock or something, but you know, then they're using a shock on my 1-1, so it's not that bad for me, really. I think I'd actually rather kill this than give them the Kenra in their graveyard. I'm going to have to kill Kenra eventually, probably, but... if they have a spell, why in the world would not do that first? Well, I don't know. I don't know exactly what happened in that, you know, one little spot, but... Alright. I'm in a little bit awkward spot where, like, I would like to be able to make more guys with my Rogue Refiner, but I also want to be able to cast Magma Spray and just in general red spells. But I think I want to cast this, because I think I want to Magma Spray next turn. Or they want to do that, whatever. Ooh, that was the most maximum punishment there. Man. Stack might be really greedy. I just don't really have, like... I don't have a good way to, like, pull ahead and gain some advantage, so I kind of don't really want to just sit here, like... I can take one from a Soul Scar Mage. I want a Magma Spray the Earthshaker Kenra anyway. If they have a Hazoret, I'm probably just going to play a 1-1 or make a 1-1 to chump block it. Alright, well. Now I'm going to shock the other guy. Stupid me. I forgot I could not do both things. That was bad. That was bad. All don't particularly want to have to use this energy because I want to be able to like cast Glorybringer next turn. So maybe I just pass turn. Like if they make my Glistering Hydra unable to attack, I can just Whirler. Like just block with actual Whirler. Alright. Well, that's good for me. Well, Swamp doesn't do a ton. I don't think I, like, really die to anything here. At least not immediately, and I'm going to deal a lot of damage to them, so. It's like, this sort of how this matchup has to be. Like, you can't just sit back forever and hope to take total control, because, like, the, like, Hazoret can just kill you. You know, you can chump block at some with Whirler Virtuoso, but you have to be, like, cracking back with Glorybringer or something. Like, you can't just expect to actually win with that. I don't know if they can even really attack here. Really? Okay. Let's see here. So, it is unlikely they're going to have ways to kill both of my blockers if I leave one guy back. So I could just, like, leave Scare, or leave a Whirler back and play Scarab God and just only attack with Blistering Hydra. Then I also have a Magma Spray. I think that's fine. Scarab God, not a particularly good card against them. I mean, it can remove an Earthshaker Kenra before it gets brought back, but you know. I'm looking for a little more out of my card. It's probably a little better after sideboard because they do side out a bunch of one drops and bring in big creatures, but alright, so I think we do not want to let this deck. Well, we could have brought back their other Oncop Crasher that turn and made it so they super couldn't block, but alright. Well, I definitely want Chandra's Defeat and these Aether Sphere Harvesters. I don't actually love these because, I think they side some amount of stuff out, and also some amount of it like comes back from the graveyard, and just it's not like Zombies like has to build a big board against you to win. That's not really how this deck works. So I don't think this is good. I don't think this is good, but I do want to try it. Like, I have had a game where it would have been a good way to kill Hazoret. Like, I actually had 8 lands and cast Chandra and revealed that, so if I had the 9th land, it would have been... or drawn it the next turn or whatever. Ended up losing to Hazoret, but it seemed at least okay. And then I'm not sure what else I'm supposed to take out. It's like, Chandra's not particularly good, but it does kill Glorybringer. And it still, like, is okay. So I'm not sure that I should really be taking out things that kill Glorybringer. But we just have, like, a lot of mediocre cards. I mean, you could take out, like, Long Tusk Cub or something, I guess. Like, not in this exact case, because it is actually really good here, Whirler Virtuoso, but, like, Virtuoso and Long Tusk Cub are kind of the cards where, like, if you're just trying to shave, I think they're the... probably the best ones to shave, like, because Rogue Refiner, while it's never insane or anything in any matchup, it just, like, kind of keeps the deck running smoothly, so I don't ever want to side that out. Yeah. It's just, you don't know exactly how big they're going to go, where, like, is a raid going to actually be good? It's like, Sky Sovereign is probably fine against them post-sideboard. Let's give this a try. We do have a decent amount of, like, stuff to pull ahead. Maybe slightly too little. Like, maybe we still want one Scarab God or one Sky Sovereign or something. But I don't know what to cut. Probably cutting a braid. Or a long tusk cub. Not sure. I guess I want to try Sky Sovereign against them. Let's go with that. Could also just be right to cut Magma Spray, but I do like not having to worry about Earthshaker Kenra. Alright, well, no one drop, already a good start. And we don't need the swamp for anything, so we just want a mountain. Just make it big enough so I can't misclick. Probably should have done that a long time ago, since I feel like I'm always at risk of that. Alright, well, I kind of hope to play Hazorite this game so I can see if this coup should be in my deck. I guess given that they haven't done anything yet, it probably will not be too slow. Well, I guess I could just Magma Spray this and just, like, Harvester later. But I could, like, attune and Magma Spray this turn. I think it's probably better to just, like, Magma Spray next turn. So then the question is, do I play Harvester or do I play Rogue Refiner? Like, Rogue Refiner forces them to exert, but obviously Harvester is, like, you want to attack with it as soon as possible. I think I want a Harvester. Jeez. I think I need to kill one of these. And I think I should probably just attack. Well, the getting is good. They could just have a braid or something, so there's not a one mana spell that can kill my Harvester. Glorybringer? That'd be bad for me. This is a lot of copies of this card. I see no exerts. Not worried about me untapping my guy. Well, if they have a braid, that's pretty bad for me, but I don't think never crewing my guy is a good solution either. And my Hydra is actually a pretty good thing to have against this, so. I'll crew and hope for the best. I guess I could make them waste mana on their turn. This is, like, slightly better, but. Well, it looks like this is working, so that's pretty good for me. Of course, I said I hope to play Hazoret, but, like, that'd be pretty bad for me, I guess, so I hope they don't play Hazoret. Glorybringer? That's also bad for me. Jeez. All parts of this. Doing all of it. I could just coup one of these stupid things and crew with it. I'm at 10 and they have a 3-3. I don't think I care about it. Like, I don't think I can, like, just automatically die after that or whatever. Yeah, that probably is fine. An island or a forest. No, I need a forest because I need to reveal the game trail. I have to figure out, should I be pumping this at all? I can pump twice and still have like one pump left and plenty of energy for Harvester, so that seems okay to do. Like, I do want to kill them as soon as possible. Oh, well, I didn't really mean to reveal a card. Okay.
Well, like I said, I think this is the deck I'm going to be playing tomorrow. I have an RPTQ, I guess, unfortunately. I
wish I did not have to play that. But, you know, it's still, I'm kind of looking forward to it because I think this deck seems pretty sweet. And I hopefully the Scarab God is as good as it looked, at least in, you know, the previous round here. But, thanks for watching, guys. And I will see you next draft, or I guess... video. I always do drafts. But yes, next standard video, but probably it will be a draft. All right, bye.